I used to have a rule that I implemented for myself. No technology within arm's reach of the bed. However, ever since I got an M1 iPad Pro, that rule has been absolutely shattered. What's going on, guys? My name's David Tomich. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're looking at the M1 iPad Pro from somebody who's owned it literally from day one when it came out. If you haven't seen that video where I talked about the M1 iPad Pro for architects when I first got it and all the pros and cons I saw for justifying the purchase, I'll link it up top and down below so you can check it out. But today I wanted to share with you my long-term thoughts of owning this device. It's been just under 6 months now since I received the delivery and took ownership of the highly expensive M1 iPad Pro. And to this day, it has been incredible. There definitely has been some shortfalls, which I'll get into a little bit later on, but I wanted to start with some great news because it has been the be-all, end-all for me moving into the Apple ecosystem. Now, like I said in the intro of this video, I used to have that rule, no technology within arm's reach of the bed. That meant no phone, no laptop, no iPad, no nothing. And genuinely, I stuck to that rule for as long as I can remember, because still to this day, my phone sits on the other side of the room, plugged in on the floor, because I don't want any distractions before I go to bed. However, the iPad actually completely shattered this rule and changed the game for me. It is the only device that sits literally on my bedside table. From the moment I wake up, it's picked up, and from the moment I go to bed, it's put back down. It does not leave my side. It is the ultimate all-in-one computer iPad experience, absolutely everything. Now, from somebody who's been a massive Samsung user and a Windows user for so long, I really pushed myself into not going down the Apple ecosystem. Unfortunately for me, I bought the M1 iPad Pro and am now contemplating all my other decisions in life. I'm thinking about switching my Samsung S20 Ultra to the new iPhone. I'm thinking about scrapping this computer when the new iMacs come out in the larger 27-inch models, yet to be confirmed. But I've just completely changed my whole way of thinking about technology because of this simple device. This device genuinely makes everything so easy. I've been able to split it up into two categories, basically dividing it between personal life and work life and managing that balance so much better than I ever could before. Previously, I'd be carrying around my laptop and my phone and having my work emails on one and my personal emails on another and then having all my business essentials on a completely third device. Now, I've been able to integrate that so seamlessly and so smoothly in the M1 iPad Pro, and it has been able to handle every single task I've thrown at it. Not once have I had an issue with this iPad as yet. Looking at it from a pure performance beast of a system, that's the genuine reason why I bought the iPad Pro. It has been able to stand up to the test of time. I use this thing religiously throughout the day. I'll wake up, like I said, I'll pick up my iPad, and from about 7:30 till about 9 p.m., there'll be some sort of activity being done on this iPad. Either be it marking up architectural plans, going through 3D plans with clients, or even doing AR tours with the actual iPad, I'm using a hell of a lot of RAM and as much battery life as I can possibly chew. I don't think there's been a time just yet where I've completely drained the battery. I have come very, very close, and that's because I left it open on my desk whilst I was working on my computer, absolute max brightness, and just left it on all day. It lasted about 6 hours before it completely died, but I learned my lesson pretty quick. Just simply drag that brightness down to at least 75% and it lasts forever. I think I could easily use this iPad 2 days straight, maybe even pushing it to 3 days straight of general day-to-day activities and not have to charge it, which has been a phenomenal advantage that I didn't even know I really needed in an iPad because I do charge it every single night. But knowing that you're going to be able to make it through that entire day with one single charge has been game changing. From the performance side as well, like I said, I've been doing a lot of AR and a lot of VR with this system. The AR capabilities with that built-in LiDAR scanner have made it incredible. I'm able to bring up full 3D models of houses, of buildings, of skyscrapers, and show them directly in front of the client and present them with something that they've never seen before. So it has been really versatile in all sorts of aspects to be able to really keep up with the high demand and high graphics capabilities that I need personally as an architect. Now, having said all this, there are some slight cons to the iPad Pro. First of all, I dropped my iPad Pro outside and it landed smack bang on a rock. Now, thank God it did not crack. The iPad has a couple minor scratches. Somehow, absolute miracle, it did not shatter into a million pieces. My heart sank when I dropped the iPad. I was on site doing a 3D LiDAR scan, scanning an entire environment and actually creating a video here for YouTube. Then I slipped, fell, and dropped the iPad. I genuinely thought I'd be picking that iPad up and looking at an absolute nightmare of a screen. Now, I picked it up, and to my disbelief, there was literally one tiny scratch on the screen, on the corner, that basically can't even be seen from a day-to-day operation point of view. So the durability, first of all, from this iPad has been phenomenal. I'm not one to go around bashing and beating the iPad around, so I wouldn't really take my review of durability as the best thing ever and that you can go around throwing it off cliffs and doing whatever you want with it. It still is a fragile device, but it is a lot more robust than I previously would have anticipated, which is really reassuring considering the price tag of the device. That was literally one of the only times that I took it out of the Magic Keyboard and used it as an iPad without the Magic Keyboard. Now, the Magic Keyboard for me is an accessory that I would not go without. It fundamentally changed the iPad from being just your basic run-of-the-mill tablet to actually being able to replace my laptop. I do have a very, very high-end laptop that costs double what this iPad costs, and I never use it, ever. It literally sits on the desk next to me, never getting used. I've put it up for sale because it just doesn't have a purpose anymore. So the iPad has been able to replace pretty much all of my emails on my phone, all of my emails, and all of my work on a laptop. There is one major downside to this iPad Pro, and this is just me being pedantic and me being picky. The iPad Pro in itself is ultra light, ultra slim, and just phenomenally designed. However, once you magnetically click that on to the actual Magic Keyboard, well, all of a sudden that weight goes through the roof. It literally doubles in overall weight. Now, in a small little compact package, you wouldn't think too much of it. But when you have to carry this around all day, every day, it does become a small little burden. Now, the simple fact that this keyboard is just that little bit too heavy is a bit disappointing over the last 6 months, because I do wish that this keyboard was a little bit lighter. The keyboard in itself has lasted phenomenally well. As you see, I'll do a little bit of a B-roll here over the top of this. The actual surfaces have lasted really, really well. It gets thrown into bags, into backpacks. It's been on airplanes. It's been in the little luggage compartments. It's been on the car back seats. It's been on site. It's been in the sand. It's literally been everywhere that you would take a regular notebook and a regular notepad, and it survived everything. I've spilt water on it. I've spilt coffee on it. There has been some pretty bad accidents with this iPad, but it survived it all and without a single fault so far. The only thing the iPad has not been able to replace is my actual architectural work on a computer. Now, having said that, I do believe it has the core capabilities through the RAM and the M1 chip to actually run these programs, but unfortunately, these programs aren't available on a tablet, so I can't even go and test it out. All in all, would I recommend the M1 iPad Pro 6 months after owning it, using it every single day, basically religiously, and pushing it to its absolute limits? Yes. Yes, I 100% would recommend the iPad Pro. I have not had any genuine issues with this device that I would go, I wish I didn't buy that device. And coming from me, that's actually a pretty big deal. Personally, I always buy a device and a couple months later I go, you know what? This wasn't the best choice, or this wasn't the best way I could have spent my money. For the first time, genuinely, I think the iPad Pro with the M1 chip able to handle so much more than it ever could before and genuinely actually do what they stated in the keynote has been revolutionary and game changing. And on that note, that's all for me today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you got the information you were looking for today, and I do hope that the information I provided at least provided you with some reassurance that if you're going to go out and spend a couple $1,000s on a tablet, at least you know you're gonna be getting your money's worth. If you have any questions about the iPad Pro or anything we've talked about today, check out the links in the description below. There's some good information, some good resources, some Discord chat so we can continue talking about this. And there is also the comment section down below that I obviously check all the time. If you did enjoy this video, please make sure you smash that like button and the subscribe button. The like button helps with the YouTube algorithm. The subscribe button just genuinely tells me that you're enjoying this content and you want to see more of it. But that is genuinely all from me, so I'll see you guys next Monday.